Hello friends, welcome to my channel Tutel Age. So today we are going to see chapter 4 basic geometrical idea. In that we are going to see exercise 4.5 and 4.6. So come, let's get into the video. So your first question is, draw a rough sketch of quadrilateral PQRS. So you have to draw a rough sketch of quadrilateral PQRS. I have drawn a rough sketch. Okay. Draw its diagonals. You have to draw the diagonals. Let us name them. If they also asked you to name it, so I am naming A, B, C, D, and the center point as O, meeting point as O. If the meeting point of the diagonals is in the interior or exterior of the quadrilateral. So they are asking whether the meeting point is in the interior or exterior of the quadrilateral. Can you able to see O is where it is? It is in the interior, right? So O is in the interior of the diagonal. So that is your answer. O, midpoint O is in the interior of the diagonal. So this is your answer. Now we will move on to the next sum. So this is your next sum. Draw a rough sketch of quadrilateral KLMN. State two pairs of opposite sides, two pairs of opposite angles, two pairs of adjacent sides, two pairs of adjacent angles. So let's see one by one. Two pairs of opposite sides. What is two pairs of opposite sides? It is KL and then MN. Okay, KL, MN is your two pairs of opposite sides. Two pairs of opposite angles. So angle K and angle M, comma angle L and angle N. See, these two are opposite angles, these two are opposite angles. Okay, now two pairs of adjacent sides. So what is adjacent sides? KL, KN. KL, KN is one adjacent side and then NM, LM is another adjacent sides. NM, ML is another adjacent sides. Okay. Next, two pairs of adjacent angles. So adjacent angles, angle K, angle N. Angle K and angle N. Angle L and angle M. So this is two pairs of adjacent angles. Now with this your exercise 4.5 is completed. Now let's move on to the next exercise 4.6. So this is exercise 4.6, your next sum. From the figure is given here, you have to identify the following. So we will go one by one. First, the center of the circle. So what is the center of the circle? Is point O. So the center of the circle is point O. Do you understand? Okay, next. 3 radii. What is 3 radii? OA, OB, OC. You know, diameter equal to R by 2. Okay, so radii is OA, OC and OB. OA, OC, OB are 3 radii. And diameter. See, the diameter, the passing through the center of the circle is your diameter. So that is AC. AC is your diameter. Okay. Next, a chord. Chord. ED is a chord. Chord is nothing but which will not pass through the center, but if it is passing through the center is also a chord only. Then here some other line like this having means that is a chord. ED is a chord. Passing through the circle, a line passing through the circle. Interior points. Next, interior points. What are the interior points? Here one point P will be there. We forgot. Point O and point P. O comma P is your interior points. Exterior points. So you see exterior, only this point is having, so it is Q. A sector. You see, this is a sector. AOB is a sector. A segment. A segment means ED is a segment. Okay. ED is a segment. Hope you understand. ED is a segment. Now let's move on to the next sum. So your next sum is just like one word. I will just read it out to you. You listen. Is every diameter of a circle is also a chord. So every diameter of a circle is also a chord, they are asking. So this is a diameter, it is also a chord. Just in your previous sum, I just told to you. So it is a diameter, it is also a chord. Okay. Yes, every diameter of a circle is also a chord. What I said is only they are saying every diameter of a circle is also a chord. Is every chord of a circle also a diameter? So every chord. Here I am drawing a chord. Okay, here I am drawing a chord. This is a diameter they are asking. No, right? Because diameter will pass through the center of the circle. So every diameter is a chord, but not every chord is a diameter. This is wrong. This is right. Do you understand? Okay. Now we'll move on to the next sum. So this is your next sum. They asked you to draw any circle and mark. Okay, you have to draw any circle and you have to mark it. Okay, so I am drawing the same circle. Now I am going to write which is the center. Which is the center here? Point O. What are the radius? AO, OC, OB are your radius. Okay, diameter. Which is the diameter here? AC. So which is the sector here? Already I told you same like that sum. AOB is your sector. Now your next question is say true or false. I'll just read it out to you. Two diameters of a circle will necessarily intersect. Two diameters will necessarily intersect. So if there is diameter like this and diameter like this, this condition is true or not? True. So two diameters of a circle will intersect. Okay, true. Next one, the center of the circle is always in its interior. The center, see, you take a circle and the center of the circle is always there in interior. It is not lying exterior. The center of the circle is always there in interior. So the given statement is true. So with this I am completing chapter 4. Very easy chapter containing only six exercises in which there is only easy sums. So chapter 4 is completed. In your upcoming videos, let's move on to the next chapters. So if you like my video, please like, share, subscribe and comment, and also click the bell button for updates. So thank you friends. Thanks for watching. Bye.